Since the first cases of HIV were reported in the 1980s, an estimated 78 million people have been infected with HIV, while 35 million have died from AIDS-related illnesses.
But much more has been achieved in the areas of HIV prevention, diagnosis and treatment. Here with us to discuss how we can push harder towards ending the AIDS epidemic are Professor Leo Yi Sin, Director of the Institute of Infectious Diseases and Epidemiology at Tan Tock Seng Hospital in Singapore.
And Professor Roy Chan, President of Singapore-based non-government group Action for AIDS. Welcome to the show this morning. We're going to kick things off by talking about the 1990-90 targets. So perhaps you can first explain what those are.
Well, 1990-90, I think, is a fantastic goal set by UNAIDS. It just means that we want to diagnose 90% of HIV-infected individuals in the community. And out of these 90%, we want at least 90% of them access to care. And of these 90% of people access to care, we want 90% of them that can achieve complete virus suppression. So I think it is a very beautiful, you know, targets and slogans that we can follow. And I think this is something that we strive towards.
Okay, Prof. Chan, let's bring you in. How is Asia faring in trying to achieve these targets set for 2020?
Seems quite ambitious.
It is ambitious. I think it's an aspirational goal. The whole idea was if these 390s were reached, the mathematical modeling was that by 2030, they would be able to, the global effort would be able to drop the number of new infections to a fraction. As to how it's faring, now these, when it was introduced in 2014, these are 2020 goals. Now it's 2016. I think that the goals are still quite far away. The most recent estimates was that around 60+% of the first 90, about 40+% of the second 90, and about 30+% of the third 90 have been achieved. So I think the goalposts will have to be shifted. Irrespective of that, I think that this framework has given us an idea of where we are in controlling the epidemic and treating the numbers of infected people. And every country actually is now looking at their own epidemic and planning their programs according to this framework.
Professor Leo, what are some of the challenges that are slowing progress in this part of the world?
Well, I think, looking at 1990-90, it's a nice aspiration, and I think it's important for us to put in more effort in prevention. So over the years, we know that with HIV treatment, you can reduce the viral load of the individual significantly and render the persons relatively not infectious. So I think this is one of the targets that we want to look at in terms of treating those HIV-positive individuals. But I think the more important thing is to be able to test adequately so that we know the individuals who are HIV infected and for treatment as early as possible.
There's still very much a concern about growing numbers in adults and young girls.
Yeah, the numbers of new infections have sort of plateaued. In fact, if you look at the global figures, they are dropping slightly. Certainly, not everybody is equally at risk. Certain groups, key populations, have to be targeted in our prevention campaign. So in terms of testing, we need to get testing much easier into community. We have to really reconsider ways of providing home testing or even self-testing and addressing issues that might arise. So how do we get people who self-test into care? How do we get counselling and support for those who test positive immediately? So we have to work on programs that really can deliver testing much more easily.
As part of the prevention strategy, pre-exposure prophylaxis, PrEP, it's being touted as an option. Can you tell us about this and why people are quite excited about this?
Well, I think this is not a new concept. For years, we are using post-exposure prophylaxis, meaning that the individuals had an exposure and they come for treatment with the use of anti-HIV medications. Now we are making it one step ahead to identify populations or individual at risk, and we offer this as part of the prevention strategies. I think it's important to take this PrEP as one of the prevention strategies, one of the elements that we can help in terms of reducing HIV transmissions.
Can we ask which parts of Asia would most urgently need this option to be made available?
The UNAIDS, WHO, the US CDC have recommended this as prevention for any community, any country where there is concentrated epidemics, where they can see that certain groups of people benefit from it more. It's important to also remember this particular PrEP, which we have now, which is one tablet a day of a pill called Truvada, is really the first step in a new approach to prevention. As we speak, there are studies looking into using antiretroviral drugs impregnated into, for example, vaginal rings, which can last a month. There are studies looking into using injectable forms, nano suspensions of antiretrovirals that will last for a month. So, you know, very exciting. This is the first step. It's available. It's been shown, this particular pill, by randomized trials and also rollouts in the community. It is acceptable. It is effective. And people will use it if provided the chance. So I think this is the first, we're on the cusp of a new way of preventing.
Well, you say if they have a chance, but what about cost? Is that a factor? Is it going to be expensive?
Cost is always going to be a factor. I know in Thailand, in Vietnam, where they're having big rollouts and the medication is affordable, it will be taken up. So we need to work on the cost.
Can you tell us maybe some of the services or programs that need to be placed to ensure that we are on the right track? I know that there's talk that treating HIV shouldn't be taken in isolation, that you want it treated in conjunction with other diseases and infections like TB, cervical cancer and Hep C?
Well, I think there's still quite a lot of work we need to do to relook into how can we normalize HIV, which means that it is just one of the many chronic diseases where the individuals need to live with and continue to live a normal life. I think there's still a lot that we need to do to look into this normalcy for the HIV-infected individuals. But I think I just want to come back to this 1990. I think it's very important to carry this message forward in a sense that we have to look at multiple-pronged approach in how we can put together the prevention strategies. Today, I can say that in terms of medical treatment, most of the Singaporeans, people who reside in Singapore that require HIV treatments, they have access to treatment. So treatment part of it, I think we have done a big way in terms of the making sure that the medications are accessible to the people who need treatment. So I think now the focus is that how can we further prevent new HIV infected cases? And it's a multi-pronged approach. PrEP is one of them.
Is there anything else you'd like to add on, you'd like to see happening from today onwards? Right.
I know we've been working this a long time. I think one of the issues which has continued to grip and continued to be an obstacle to effective prevention and treatment is really trying to reduce or stop the stigma and discrimination of individuals with HIV. And we have come some way over years of pushing and goading and encouraging and changing attitudes. And we still need in our own minds, you know, to talk to people about it and to really accept the fact that, you know, but person living with HIV is not a criminal. Mm-hmm. Person has got a condition which needs treatment, and we really need to get to help him or her get to the treatment.
Yeah, the stigma has to stop. Yeah, yes.
That's a Thank great you. Message to end on. Well, we've been speaking with Professor Leo E. Sin from Tan Tock Seng Hospital in Singapore and Professor Roy Chan from Action for AIDS Singapore.